So hi Tina, welcome.
Hi.
I've been dying to ask this question, you know. The whole talk is always about size zero and how nutrition can make you get to this size zero figure. We hear it from Kareena, we hear it from all these actresses. So is it actually possible that with a nutritious diet, and I'm putting nutritious diet, that can you get to a size zero?
Yes, you can, but it takes a long time. Okay, so with a nutritious diet combined with exercise, you can get to a size zero, but it will take time. There are no fast, there are no shortcuts to get to a size zero with a nutritious diet. You either have to starve yourself, spend hours working out, take a lot of lipotropic injections and stuff like that if you want to get to a size zero very quickly.
Since you just mentioned injections, Tina, and because of Sridevi, you know, there have been a lot of speculations doing the round. There was one which said that she was taking hydroxyl, which is not even FDA approved, but apparently the function of that injection is to curb your hunger or put your body into starvation mode. I don't know exactly what it does, but you hear a lot of people now using injections also, as you said. What do you have to say about that?
So, like I said, the hydroxyl that apparently she was taking is a lipotropic injection. So, again, anything that you inject in your body. See, when we take food in, the food has to be broken down and then you gradually assimilate whatever you're eating and it goes into your bloodstream in a very slow fashion. Okay. When you're taking an injection or a shot, it is given to you intramuscularly and it goes directly into your bloodstream, raising your heart rate. Okay, so by the end of it, when we're talking about the heart or when we're talking about blood pressure, anything that you inject directly into your bloodstream will cause the blood pressure to go up, will cause the heart to work harder, okay, thus increasing your chances of having maybe a stroke, having maybe an angina, or maybe having a cardiovascular disease or having a heart attack. So taking lipotropic injections is not advisable. I mean, I know a lot of people today, in today's day and age, want, like we said, the shortcut to get there where they want to get in a much faster and a quicker fashion. Mm-hmm. But no, I don't think that's a good way to go.
You don't support that. Okay.
So what do you think is like a nutritious diet then? What kind of a diet should we follow if we want to be healthy and still maintain our weight?
So I go by the American Dietetic Association. They put out a food guide pyramid where we have everything, all the food groups are broken down into serving sizes. So like you have your bread group, then you have your fruits and vegetables, then you have your milk, dairy, you have your protein, and then you have your fats. So they recommend what we call as recommended allowances, which are DRIs. So if you eat according to that and exercise, then I think you can get to a healthy weight, keep a healthy weight, and also get nutritionally balanced food.
Now, a couple of questions. People are saying that, okay, don't eat carbs or no calorie counting. Are these like new fads that have come up?
Yes, absolutely. So there are three macronutrients that we work with. We work with carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, okay? When carbohydrates break down, they give you energy. It's calorie. That's the basic unit of energy. So your body runs on the right fuel that it's supposed to be running on. You must have heard of this keto diet that's doing the rounds these days. Mm-hmm. What is a keto diet? They give you a high fat and a high protein diet. When protein breaks down, it results in ketones. Okay, the body does not like ketones. There is only one way of getting the ketones out of your body, which is you urinating them.
Yes.
Once you're urinating the ketones, every time you urinate, it passes through your kidney. Now the kidney gets, every time you pass ketones through your kidney, the kidney gets affected. So yes, it's quick weight loss. It's, and people are swearing by it. Obviously, if you're 100, 110 kgs, you pick up any diet, whether a keto diet, whether where you're in a hurry, or whether you take a well-balanced, nutritious diet in which you take time to lose the weight, your medical conditions are going to resolve. When we talk about conditions like diabetes, blood pressure, cholesterol,
thyroid,
obesity, thyroid, PCOD, they're all related to a weak gut, which is a weak metabolism. There are ways of bumping the metabolism, which is faster injectables, keto diets, low-carb diets, high-protein diets, and then there is also the healthy way of doing it. Sure enough, you're not going to get the result in 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, but with what recently happened, I mean, now is the question to ask yourself, I want to get there, but do I want to get there very quickly and hurt myself, or do I want to take time and get there and be confident that I'm doing it the right way?
One more question. Oh, sorry.
Yeah,
go ahead.
No, just related to that, I was wondering, so the right way is to go slowly, but how do you make it appealing? How do you make food appealing? Because, you know, having just
the nutritious, the so-called nutritious food appealing for us, for children, for everybody, you know, because we're used to a particular kind of food.
Right. So you can make food appealing in ways, you know, that are liked by your family. So, for example, I mean, when people come to me and ask, I do a lot of child nutrition these days. So we have these kids who are ready to go to college. So the parents are worried that the children are going to be by themselves there. Then we have picky eaters at home. Then we have, children who are insulin resistant, who are gaining weight rapidly, are developing at risk of developing diabetes. So I get a lot of these parents coming to me and saying, how my child does not eat this. How can I make the child eat healthy, and along with that, make sure that the child is able to maintain or lose weight? My answer to these kind of questions is that you don't stop your child from eating whatever they want. Of course, not junk food. And maybe, so what I do is I put a forbidden list. Okay, so in my forbidden list, I have things like sugar, saturated fats, ice cream, chips, desserts, things that a normal mother would say, okay, this is junk food. And I tell the child, you know, whenever you go to my forbidden list, exercise more.
Okay, that's a great idea.
Yeah, so exercise more. It's okay. I mean, if you have a sibling who's normal weight, and if you have a sibling who's overweight, and once in a while everybody orders pizza, once in a while everybody wants to have that pastry. So what if you do? Just go ahead and work it out. So that's the forbidden list. If you choose a food out of the forbidden list, work it out. If you're having, let's say, for example, if you're doing waffles, or you're doing with maple syrup and waffles in the morning for breakfast, and you're doing butter chicken with butter naan for lunch, and you do like a button biryani for dinner, that's going out all the way, right? But what if you have a waffle with maple syrup for breakfast and choose to have a normal, healthier lunch, and maybe choose to have something more healthier for dinner, like maybe a grilled chicken or a salad or some sprouts or, a scrambled egg or things like that? You're balancing your day's calories as well as nutrition. Now, I know we're not doing we're not focusing too much on calorie counting these days, and we're more focused on eating healthy, the portion control, and exercising. So take it that route. Whichever route you take it, it doesn't matter. By the end of it, eat whatever you want. Moderation is the key.
So Dr. Tina, my question is very different, because I eat a lot of healthy food, and I feel that nowadays, since there's too much information about chia seeds, this, that, everything, so everybody is trying to eat, at least me, I try to eat as much healthy as possible. But you don't know how and what do you put those things in your, like, I have a choice of eating healthy. I love eating healthy food. But I really don't know that, how do you balance it out? What portion of what? Even chia seeds or flax seeds or milk or dairy products, salad, whatever.
So all these seeds that are coming out, they're basically rich in antioxidants, okay? So whether you take chia, whether you take pumpkin, whether you take sesame, they're all healthy. In terms of how much you should be consuming it, again, they have calories. So we base it on your calorie, on your daily caloric intake. How much calories do you want? So like, for example, including making food, if you're having chia seeds just by themselves in the morning, you can make a smoothie out of it. You put milk, you put a fruit, you put peanut butter, and you put chia seeds. You have a carb group. You got the fruit, you got the protein, and
so
you got
everything
chia seeds,
in one.
Everything in one.
Yeah.
Okay, so you make a smoothie and top it with chia seeds or pumpkin seeds or with sesame seeds. You can make a trail mix, you know, have a few nuts, almonds, walnuts, mix some seeds in it, and that you can use as a snack. It's a high calorie, high energy, good filling snack.
So right mix, right balanced.
So yeah, that's what I think we're learning. Moderation.
Moderation is the key. Moderation is the key.
Dr. Tina, one more question related to this. We've been hearing about milk. So, you know, milk was always touted as a woman should always have milk because, you know, we
calcium,
we need it more than anybody else. But the latest things in the news are saying that it causes cancer because of all the hormones.
It does. So I'm not saying it does. I mean, cancer can be caused. Cancer is a body's response to something that's been, you know, put in the body, or the body, you don't know how cancer is caused. Okay, the body just triggers itself against something that may be present in your blood already, or you've recently started taking. Milk does increase your chances of having cancer or having other medical conditions, because yes, milk comes from animals, but then so does cheese, so does dahi, so does meat, chicken. I mean, organic farming or organic milk or organic eggs. We're moving more towards organic, but can you really be sure? Are you taking in organic? So you might as well just not eat anything. You know, you just might as well take a pill,
right,
and then just meet your nutrition needs, hope that you don't develop any one of these.
As you said last time about women taking calcium, so you were saying some data where...
Yes, so recently we've been coming across a lot of women, and there was a study done by the IDA, and it was concluded at AIIMS and Safdarjung. And where we found out that even more than cardiac disease, women are suffering, well, cardiac disease is supposed to be a man's disease, whatever, but women are suffering from knee replacements. So
calcium deficiency.
Because when, and this is the age group of 60 to 70, because maybe when they were 20, 30 years old, nobody told them to take calcium. You know, if they were economically compromised, so if they would get milk and, you know, calcium-rich products, they would give it to their families, deprive themselves. Calcium supplementation was not encouraged. So these are the women, even if they're not overweight, you know, they have such weak knees that they're needing to,
Recommend a calcium supplement for women?
Of course I do. Yes, I do.
Okay, yeah. Great. And what about just vitamins in general? Are they good?
I do. So when people come to me, I do encourage a multivitamin. I encourage a calcium and a D3. I encourage a B12 if they're vegetarian. And I tell them this is not for weight loss or weight gain. You know, this is just general. We're encouraged by the ADA to make sure people are getting all these multivitamins. And if you take our Indian cooking, you know, if we're talking about fruits and if we're talking about vegetables, by the time you buy your vegetables, you'll wash them again then you'll cook them, you'll slow cook them, kadi hui cheese honi chahiye, whatever, how much nutrition is left in there. Okay,
so Tina, how do you know we're doing the right thing? I mean, are there blood tests? Like, how do we know we're taking enough calcium? How do you know?
Well, yes, there are blood tests. Yes, so you get a basic CBC done, which will, you know, or we get tests done for vitamin D in the body. We get tests done.
So for women over 40, would you recommend this?
I actually, there was this thing, Dr. Trihan came on the news and said that over age 30, everybody nowadays should be going in for a annual health checkup, and I'm completely with it. We're all into very high stressful lives, okay? I mean, gone are those days where, you know, we used to sit at home and we had nothing to worry about. Everybody now wants everything, which leads to higher stress. We want our children to excel. We want to live in the best homes. We want to drive good cars. All that is stressful. You know, I get a lot of young generation in their early 30s, late 20s, late 30s that are working in MNCs. You know, their day starts at 8, their day ends at 11. They're living away from home, they're eating out of boxes, you know. They have in Gurgaon there's a big growth of all these I'll deliver to your desk kind of you know, meals, meal in a box, or you know, we're giving you nutritionally healthy meals. I get a lot of people sometimes saying that if you're making me a meal plan, why don't you start delivering? Like, I can't do that, you know, that's out of my bandwidth. But I mean, it's a great idea. These people are, you know, they want food given to them at their desk, you know, so stress comes in. They can't get pregnant, okay? They develop diabetes, they have blood pressure, they have elevated cholesterols. I see a lot of, the youngest actually in my clinic last week that I saw was an 11-year-old with type 2 diabetes, not even a genetically induced, but a type 2 diabetes. Junk food, you know, bariatric surgeries coming in a big way these days. You know, they're non-reversible. Girls, you know,
what's
I
that?
Work.
What?
Bariatric surgery, where you it's surgically done and they either tie your stomach or they bypass your stomach and things like that. So these days, girls who are 14, 15, 16 are, you know, who are overweight. It's the easy way out. You know, what do you tell a parent who comes in with a girl who's depressed and, you know, who's wanting to get the surgery done just because she wants to be socially accepted by her friends? You know, she doesn't have a boyfriend. She wants a boyfriend. She doesn't have friends because of the way she looks. Appearance nowadays is everything. You know, you go for a job. Forget your education. Mm-hmm. They first look at you, how presentable you are.
That's the killer.
You know, you want to get married? How presentable are you? You want to get a job? How presentable are you? You want to have a boyfriend? How presentable are you? So by the end of it, everything in today's day and age is boiling down to looks. Now, there is an easier way of getting to those looks, and then there is the harder way of getting into those looks. So like they say, you know, no pain, no gain. So you have to work it out and, you know, and get there.
So what is one thing that you say that this is a must or a takeaway for the listeners?
I would probably, you know, I would say that, you know, don't do anything in a hurry, okay? You want a size 2, you want a size 4, you want a size 0, please, get it. Everybody has the right to look the way they want to, but just do it the right way. Okay, seek medical guidance, seek somebody who's, you know, professionally sound in doing this, and do it the right way. You know, don't compromise yourself, because you never know what's going on in your body. You know, we can't predict death. Okay, when it has to come, it has to come. You could just die in a car accident, but that doesn't, after this Sri Devi episode, a lot of people just said, what's the point? You know, I mean, you can be so healthy and whatever, and you'll just go away. But that doesn't mean that you stop taking care of yourself.
That is true.
So you have to take care of yourself. Do it the right way. Feel good about what you're doing. So I always end by saying what the American Dietetic Association says. They say, ask yourself three questions and you'll know you're on the right path. Is this diet something that you will do for the rest of your life? Meaning, is it a part of your lifestyle? Does this diet include exercise? Okay, and does this diet restrict you on going out with your family? So, you know, if you're on an all basin or an all paneer diet, your family wants to go to a Chinese meal. What do? Sit there and look at their faces?
Right.
No. How flexible is it? Is it something that you can do for the rest of your life? Does it include exercise? If you answer yes to all these three questions, you're on the right path.
Very good. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay.